going cold with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. This episode is actually filmed in 2020, and I'm finally re-airing it now on my channel in 2022. Time flies when you're having fun. This video I filmed at the MJ BizCon, and it was quite sad that I put it up, and a few of you guys got to watch it, and then all of a sudden YouTube just basically took it down. And they said it was a violation of some kind of rule, which they didn't actually tell me. I appealed it. They still did not allow me to have the video up. So now I have an editor, and I had the editor basically bleep out. Anytime I say the word bleep, you could figure out what that word is. Basically, to me, this video is about gardening and how to grow the best, you know, food, fruits, vegetables, herbs, or whatever you want to grow. And I think it's sad that it's being censored by YouTube because they deem it to be something wrong with it. And I don't exactly know what. I think it's like some kind of content violation, and they wouldn't say exactly what. So I've kind of tried to edit this video down. I might have took out like one of the vendors or something just to make sure that this video is going to pass the muster so that this video and all the information inside this video can be accessible to you guys, because it is very important information that I believe should be available for free and for people to watch if they want. In any case, let's get into this episode where you will learn a lot about growing different kind of herbs, vegetables, and fruits at the MJ BizCon.
All right, this is John Colin with growingyourgreens.com to have another exciting episode for you. And today I'm actually not in my garden. I'm actually in a big convention center, probably one of the largest in the world, and actually they're expanding and making it even bigger. I'm here in Las Vegas, Nevada, and this is the site of the 2019 business MJ BizCon, which is the largest conference in the entire world. And I'm bringing this to you guys because, you know, or whatever you want to call it, hemp. These all come under the classification of are basically plants that, in my opinion, have been villainized and demonized by the U.S. government and other governments around the world, and it should basically just be respected for what it is. It's a plant that has special properties that are not in other plants. I mean, here's the thing. Every plant is literally a chemical factory, right? It gets sunlight, it gets nutrition from the soil, it gets microbial interaction, and different properties and different nutrients, phytochemicals, plant metabolites, whatever you want to call them, basically come out, right? So whether I'm growing purple basil or whether I'm growing my ashitaba or gynera procumbens, you know, many different herbs from around the world have been grown for thousands of years and used beneficially. Unfortunately, has a really bad connotation because people think it's an evil drug, and especially if you guys were younger and you saw the movie Reefer Madness, when, like my dad did when he was in school, he thought made you crazy. And, you know, hopefully in this video I help to dispel that a little bit, but this episode is not really focusing on the conference. You know, I'll talk a little bit about that, but basically more about some of the vendors and the exhibitors here, and that's my area of focus. You know, I have a gardening channel on YouTube, and as much as I'm a big proponent of and want to try to educate people about that, you know, I'm really about growing high quality fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, and herbs. I mean, any plant you could grow, I focus on growing the highest quality. And I'm glad to say that, you know, a lot of the techniques that I use in my very vegetable garden, because I do not presently grow or hemp, and I will say this also because you guys will think, man, John's at a convention or he's high. I don't get high. I don't actually like the psychoactive effects from the, although I do like all the beneficial effects from the other cannabinoids that are in there that are like recently discovered and now getting more research out about. So that's my preferred use. And actually, I'm a really big advocate, even more so, of the industrial hemp that does not contain the, but I also believe that it's very important to have a balance of all the different cannabinoids. And, you know, you guys feel free to use them as you see fit, provided it's legal in the state where you live, because I think, unfortunately, federally at this time, while hemp, industrial hemp, is legal nationwide for the farming bill, it is not currently legal in every state to have the, and it could get you in trouble. So I do not encourage you guys to break any laws from what you're going to learn in this episode today. But anyways, so a lot of what I've learned for using in my vegetable garden, I've learned from the industry, because those guys are always trying to raise the bar, create higher terpenes, and let's be honest, you know, this is one of the most lucrative cash crops, although that is falling out now with big business coming in. I mean, this is the largest trade show for the industry, and, you know, if you would think, yeah, John, I'm gonna go there. There's gonna be tons of stoners. Well, yeah, I have plenty of friends that are stoners and whatnot. But you know what? Imagine most of the people here are like in nice shirts and ties and like they don't appear high to me. Maybe there's, you know, a small segment of people that are just totally stoners and stuff. But this is totally about the business. This is not about just a stoner party. I mean, this is a serious event. And if you guys are at all anywhere, you know, involved with on a daily basis in the industry, I mean, seriously, this is the event you guys need to be at to educate yourself about, you know, what's going on with policy and government and with like in the industry and like the heartbeat of industry. There's like more people here that are into this stuff, specialized speakers speaking about this stuff, and more importantly for me, all the amazing vendors that just literally come out of the woodwork with products that I've never seen before that could increase and elevate your growth. So whether you're a grower or in the main business, you want to come to this event. I mean, it's been amazing. And here's the thing, right? You guys don't understand, like you guys complain about how long my videos, John, your videos are too long. Well, you guys don't understand that this is a 3-day event. It was like 10 to 6, Wednesday and Thursday. And then today it's only from like 10 to 3. And like the last 2 days, like solid 2 days, like I'm not kidding. I could not even go to any conferences, which they have. I basically just walked the exhibit floor. It took me one day to get through half the exhibit floor. And then the second day it took me basically the other half of the whole day to get through the other half of the exhibit floor. So I visited over 1,000 different booths, walked by 1,000 different booths and inspected them, you know, whether I'm just visually looking and kept walking or whether I'm stopping and talking for sometimes hours at a time to learn about some of the amazing products I'm gonna share with you guys in this video, right? It's taken me a lot of time to get all this stuff down. And if you guys came here, I mean, number one, I'm saving you guys lots of money because it ain't cheap to come to this event, but it is a business write-off. So if you're in a business, so I do recommend it. But it's a lot of my time, you know, and I don't have a big crew, right? There's me, I'm a team of one. It's me with my camera and my tripod, she's named Proline, making this video for you guys. So, you know, I want you guys to appreciate this video and watch it all the way through because, you know, there's gonna be some tidbits of really important knowledge and vendors that I'll be sharing with you guys that are just super cool. Some of them are just kind of passing, I think they're kind of cool, but, you know, literally I weeded out through like over 1,000 vendors to have like a handful. And I have all the business cards right here. This is the money right here. Don't lose these because each one basically tells me what booth to go to and what I'm filming at for you guys to share so that you guys could get this out in YouTube land because you were not able to come here. So basically, you know, this is 2 days of my time, like 15 hours. And according to my iPhone, I walked a total of, 8 miles. I walked a total of 8 miles and 15 hours of my time creating this episode behind the scenes before this is even being shot on the last day, and I only have 4 hours to film it. So hopefully I can able to fit all this stuff in this episode. So anyways, let's go ahead and get on with the show. All right, so before I head into the expo hall, I just wanted to talk about they have like a general session area. And let me tell you, I've been to lots of conferences and trade shows over the days, and like this conference or general session area was like the largest of like any I've seen. I mean, literally it was probably the size of a football field, and I'm not exaggerating, with just chairs and chairs and chairs and a big speaker stage up in front. And they had like people like senators and people really in the industry to share with you guys knowledge. And I mean, it just went nonstop, like probably first 2 days, and I think maybe half of today. Last day, they're basically having these different, seminars and presentations to educate people. And, you know, I think the thing for me that's the most sad, and I got to walk in and kind of see what it's like in there, but I could not hang out because my focus is on the total exhibitor booth. So this is a conference and expo. And whether you guys are into one or the other, I want you guys to like go to both and pick out the, you know, conferences you want to go to because they're full of information, you know. And I think for me personally, like I just barely could even get through the expo booths in the last 2 days, and I didn't even have any time for the conference. So it's like almost like you need to bring your team here so that some people can work on the conference, learn all the stuff in there, and then some people could check out the expo booths, you know, so you could basically cover it all, because as one person, I'm not simply not able to do that. Anyways, let's go over the area that interests me the most, which is the expo hall. All right, so what you guys are seeing behind me is actually the expo hall entrance, and you need a badge to get in. So luckily they gave me a press pass to be able to share this with you guys. So hey, if you guys enjoy this video, like this video, hey, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also be sure to share with other people on different forums and otherwise so that they can be aware of how cool and really cool this event was. You know, like I go to lots of expos, and once again, like this is probably the most exciting expo to me that I've been to in a long time because there's just so much cool stuff to see. And you know, I'm gonna head into the exhibit hall there, and I'll let you guys know in advance, save you guys some time. If you guys are into processing or other things, this is not the video for you guys. Like there are so many different ways to process with different extractors and butane extractors, CO2 extractors, oil-based extraction, fractional and distillate extraction, and I walk by all those booths. I don't have the time. Like, I could barely cover all the stuff having to do with growing in the last 2 days. You know, also, likewise, if you're looking for the best LED lights for right, this ain't the video you guys want to watch. There are so many lighting manufacturers, and I could barely just get through the ones that have to do with growing actually in soil without lighting to grow inside. My personal opinion is that the best is grown outdoors, if you have the right climate to do that, of course. Growing some under lighting instead of not at all is a good thing, if legal where you live. So I'm not even going to cover LED lighting, but I'm going to cover all the other things to basically grow the highest quality and also, you know, keep you in check to find out and make sure you're growing good quality stuff, including is some really cool tools that you can measure the cannabinoid content as well as determine if a product that you're producing or buying is contaminated with organophosphates and other, you know, nasty pesticides that I don't believe we should be ingesting or that should not even be used in this industry or even food industries, in my opinion. So I guess let's go ahead and head inside and show you guys some of the cool booths or exhibitors that I've seen at the 2019 MJ BizCon. All right, so this is what it looks like in the MJ BizCon. As you guys can see, I mean, it just goes on and on and on. I mean, literally, this is where they have the CES, or Consumer Electronics Show, and these halls are freaking chock full and packed of all kinds of different vendors, you know. You could also source products, so if you're looking to start your own business, you could find pre-made end product that you could basically buy and then resell. You know, there's lots of different producers looking for distributors. And once again, I'm not going to cover any of that, and I'm actually going to only cover one company that actually makes a final end product for end consumers. If you're not able to get some of the hemp or industrial hemp products near you because they are 50 state legal, you know, once again, this video is focused on the growing, and I've basically walked around every booth. Oh, the other thing you're not going to find in this episode, I'm not really going to show you guys like nutrient solutions. So like, I'm into an organic gardening method, and in my opinion, and based on experience I've seen and quality of herb and vegetables I've seen, using organic methods, especially, you know, number one, there's no toxic pesticides, man-made chemicals or pesticides on the food or the medicine that you're growing, produces higher levels of terpenes and phytonutrients and phytochemicals, vitamins and minerals, you know, in the final end product, whether you're growing hemp or any other plant for that matter. So this is only about that. I mean, you know, though there's like a house of garden nutrient, you know, line right there, this video ain't about that. This is like, this video for you guys is like next level stuff, right? I've been gardening on my YouTube channel now for 10 years, and I have a few videos on I don't grow it myself at present time because it is illegal in my state, which is the state of Nevada. And you guys will say, John, it's legal in Nevada, man. Wake up. Are you high? And yes, while it is legal, the government or the state government in Nevada basically wrote into the law that if you live within 25 miles of a dispensary, you cannot legally grow your own. You have to go through the dispensary. That's because they want the tax dollars and funnel the money, you know, through the dispensary. And so that's how it is. And until hemp laws change and that individuals could grow hemp, it was enacted in the 2000 and the current farming bill to be legal. You know, you still need to get licensed by your Department of Agriculture, as I understand it. Well, especially in my state, and I don't know about how the laws in other states. So once again, before you guys grow anything, please check your laws and don't break any laws. Also, I want to let you guys know that this video is mature content rated. So, you know, if you're under 18, turn the video off now or get your parents' permission to watch this. I may be using some explicit language, although my channel is normally a family channel. And that's just how it is, because this is the you know, conference. All right. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and start our journey to show you guys the best biologics and ways to improve your growth to get even higher terpenes, higher, you know, concentrations of all the things you guys want. And for me, I use these same techniques to grow the highest quality vegetables on the planet. All right, so now I'm going to show you guys the first vendor, and actually the first vendor is actually not necessarily going to assist you in growing products, but this is for you guys that can source any kind of good products near you or grow your own to get some of the benefits from the amazing plant, or specifically in this case, they are using industrial hemp to process into the Kanabia line of different products. And so what I'll tell you guys is this: at this convention, there's so many different vape booths, vape pens, and edibles, and, you know, to me, like, a lot of those are just garbage. I go to all the health food industry trade shows also, and actually that's where I know the Kanabia company from, because I saw them at the Natural Products Expo East, just a few months ago, and now they're here, so I'm glad to see them here to be like the positive force in this industry that has actually super clean products and products that I could definitely give my thumbs up to and I've actually been personally taking and have seen beneficial results from. And you know, they do it a lot different than some of the other companies. And you know, let's talk about ingestion. Like, how do I recommend or how do I ingest my, you know, right? So number one, I am under the belief that the whole plant is always better than its fractionates or any fraction thereof, right? So I like to eat a whole food plant-based diet, and I would encourage you guys to basically get the whole plant. So you know, the best way to get the is just to pick the leaves off, put it in your salad, man. But most people don't have the ability to do that because maybe illegal where you live, and then you get it in nature's amounts and all the different cannabinoids that are in the leaves. Of course, I also like to eat flower, eat buds. That has been problematic for me in the past when I eat a high bud, raw, non-decarboxylated, not heated. I eat it raw, and I've got higher than I've ever have in my life, and that's not supposed to happen. That has not been my personal experience. So now I'm back to eating like maybe 2-to-1, you know, a CBD bud, which is more CBD actually, than and if I eat popcorn buds, I don't seem to get the psychoactive effect that's non-desired for me, but maybe desired for you. And then the other thing I have been doing is I get industrial hemp or you know, high CBD hemp to get the benefits that way, and I just eat ground up powder basically, or just the trim is, or the biomass is what I've been eating. But that being said, I also like to take some kind of concentrate. So basically at Kanabia, they basically make a whole plant extracts, or basically full spectrum. So they're keeping all the cannabinoids in there. They're not isolating out. And I think a big problem in industry is that there's many different isolates that are being isolated out. And actually, I bought an isolate product unbeknownst to me at a dispenser, and I felt ripped off after I did that because they make a extract, but then they add CBD isolate in there to get that 10-to-1 ratio that they want to put on the bottle. And I'm not in favor of these kinds of products. I want to have natural ratios with all the different phytonutrients, phytochemicals that would be in there as much as possible. So that's why I like to eat the whole leaf or then juice it. I'll put a link down below to a video I've made how I juice raw leaves and got high for 10 hours. And I got my friend Josh high also, who does regularly consume. So the reason why I like cannabis here is because there's, you know, people know about the different cannabinoids. I mean, and CBD are the main ones, but there's so many other ones, right? And while some of the other cannabinoids may be in other products and other, you know, buds that are growing, and if you guys are looking for seeds, I would encourage you guys to get seeds that don't just have 30%. Other cannabinoids are quite beneficial, and in some cases even more important, and as research comes out, even better at anti-inflammation than like the CBD. So for example, the company here, they have basically 70% CBD, and then the other 30% of their product is the CBG, CBDV, and the THCV. Once again, these are all the non-psychoactive components. So they have a much greater percentage of these other cannabinoids that unfortunately in modern society has been bred out of the plant. And I think this is a complete travesty because everybody's been going after that because they want the psychoactive effects. Me, on the other hand, I want all the other effects besides the psychoactive effects, the anti-inflammation, you know, the peaceful, calming, restful state to get my cannabinoid receptors in my body filled so that my body could operate more efficiently, just like plants. If you give them everything they need, they're gonna be healthy, they're gonna produce more different cannabinoids and phytochemicals, phytonutrients, and plant metabolites. It's my belief that if we, the wider spectrum of nutrition we could get, including different cannabinoids and plant chemicals from every plant on the planet, the healthier we'll be and the more optimally and efficiently our bodies will run. So that's really why I like this company here. So let's go ahead and talk about a few of the products they have here. And these are the only basically packaged, you know, processed products that I would recommend at this entire place. So now I want to show you guys a Cannabia products real quick here because I don't want to spend too long in this booth. But you know, this is their flagship product. It's basically the 1,000 milligram Golden Harvest. And you know, the company here basically makes functional products that are gonna help. You know, I think a lot of people may be taking some of the different products for pain, and these are some of the most effective due to the wide range of the other cannabinoids besides the CBD, but not the, because this is from actually an heirloom industrial hemp, actually, you know, that they found that is unique and is not grown like in standard practice. And so they take extracts of this, and then they basically extract other different, you know, herbs and spices. Like they have a mixture with turmeric, actually. So they have the liquids, which you guys can get, and they also have some little capsules here. And actually, I've been taking some of the capsules myself and the liquids. I think I just ran out of my capsules a couple days ago, and then I still have the liquid that I take as a dropper full and put under my tongue. So I want to show you guys actually how to use this stuff. Super simple. You're just going to go ahead and take this. And then these are like child-proof lids, so you got to kind of press and turn. And you'll just get a dropper, and I put it on my tongue. I like to let it sit under my tongue for, I don't know, like 30 seconds minimum, swish it around. The longer it sits in there, the better absorption you're gonna get of some of the cannabinoids. Now, you know, to me, the other thing about this company here is that they have clean products. You know, some of the companies here add things like potassium benzoate, you know, sodium, all these crazy big words that like are preservatives. You're not gonna find that in these products. And the other thing is the herbs that they're also putting into these products are like CO2 extracted and extracted in the best methods to preserve the most beneficial compounds from those herbs. So like, I think this one has the ashwagandha in there. And then here's one like, oh, their new product coming out. It's not even available yet. This is the Kava Kava. So if you guys have problems sleeping, like, yeah, cannabis is good for sleeping, right? This is the formulation you want, because now this is synergistic effect with the, you know, the CBD and the other cannabinoids in this product with the Kava Kava extracted in the best way possible. And so this is probably the best cannabis sleep product you're gonna find with the Kava Kava, because traditionally Kava was used for like helping you kind of mellow out and relax if you guys are high strung. Like I better not take too much of this before I make the rest of my video here. Oh wow, man, that has a nice flavor. Oh my God, a little bit strong, but I like it a lot. Now, to be honest with you guys, my favorite are these little capsules. And this is the CBD plus Adapt. It has like the turmeric in there and ashwagandha. And it's super critical extract in herbs. You know, they usually do that with these herbs are high end too. So we're basically gonna open up, and these are veg caps. So like all the different products here at this company are vegan. I'm not a big fan of the soft gel caps. And actually, I don't even like to swallow these guys. Like, I just basically open these up and put on my tongue. And then just let it dissolve and soak in. I mean, the other thing you could take the whole capsules, like this is strong because I'm really tasting the turmeric. I don't mind strong flavors. I'm used to eating all kinds of strong stuff all the time. And I feel I get a better absorption by letting this absorb into my mouth first and then swallowing it versus just swallowing the capsules whole. Of course, you could just put this in water like they have samples here, which is really easy. So literally I came by here yesterday at the end of the day and I dosed on like, I don't know, about 5 cups of these guys. And I was, you know, feeling energetic right afterwards. So good. Now the other thing you guys could do is you could add these to food. So they've already made that really quick, easy, and convenient for you guys. So they have like their natural traditions, CBD plus golden milk turmeric latte. So if you guys like, you know, get off your coffee, get onto this stuff, heat this stuff up. It's got coconut milk, so it's nice fatty. So now you got probably better absorption from some of the cannabinoids and the turmeric in there, do the fat, and it's just gonna taste delicious, and you're gonna get your dose of the CBD plus the other cannabinoids that are in the Kanabia products. I think that's all I wanna get into. You know, I'm not really gonna plug any other, you know, finished end products here, but I did wanna let you guys know about the best company that's here at the show that has the best, you know, products I trust, because it's a guy I've known in the health food industry for like 20 years. I mean, he's solid. So if you guys wanna learn more, you can check them out at cannabia.com, and all their assays for every product is actually on their website, so you can see the differentiation between the CBD, CBG, and you know, see the big percentage of the other cannabinoids besides the CBD that most companies have the major part of, and only 1 or 2% of the other ones. You know, this company has the most. And until I find something better, this is the company I'm recommending. All right, so the first booth I'm gonna show you guys is actually a foundational product, and it's a product that I believe you should be using if you guys aren't already, no matter if you're growing organic like I want you guys to grow, or even if you're still using chems and, you know, high, just basically man-made chemicals in your hydro systems, right? The mycorrhizae and the other bacteria beneficials that come along with it can be beneficial to your grow. So let's learn more about the Plant Success brand that I've actually been personally using for at least the last 10 years, maybe nine 9 years, but I've been using them for a long time and they definitely work. All right, so now I want to show you guys more about the plant success, basically mycorrhizae, and also it contains other beneficial bacteria in there. And basically all this stuff, this is a water soluble powder. Whoa. It's super fine concentration. You guys don't want to be breathing that in. If you don't want to mix it yourself, that's all right. You know, they got a liquid product too right here for you guys. So, I mean, here's the thing, you know, 90% of plants in the world have basically the roots of the plant, like, form together and work with and have a symbiotic relationship with the mycorrhizae, right? And when mycorrhizae are on the roots, things happen better, right? More nutrient is uptake. You're gonna get higher yields, probably more disease resistant plants, and actually more resistant to like water stress. I mean, in a hydro system, that's probably not gonna happen, but if I'm in the soil and it's a drought sometimes, right? It's been shown that I think around 20, the plants are like more resistant to having less water, like 20%. And so that the microbes are super critical, super important, and in a, especially a chemical situation, right? The microbes are being disregarded in certain areas, like when you're forcing bloom, you could kill all your microbes because the PPMs are going too high. So then you need to re-inoculate this stuff. So I'd recommend, especially if you're growing like that style, to re-inoculate regularly to keep it in there. But of course, you know, if you're just growing in soil like I am, then you could put this in there once, like, and I put it on every root of every starter plant that goes into my garden, and it increases the uptake of the nutrients, and I create healthier plants with that have higher levels of phytonutrients, phytochemicals. Whether you're looking for terpenes or cannabinoids, this is going to up your grow, make it even better than before. And I mean, I'm going to talk about a lot more than just this. This is the baseline microbe product that I want you guys to use, and these are stable, you know, highly stable when you put them in the ground. Some of the other products are kind of maybe not as stable as that and strong, but these guys have been proven out. And the other thing is, there's so many different microbe companies selling mycorrhizae. Plant Success is the one I want you guys to use, and here's why, right? Some companies have like dominator species in one kind, right? To me, nature's not just about one kind of something, right? We want to have like a diversity and mixture of all different kinds of people on the planet that do all different kinds of things. And think we only had like lawyers on the planet, and everybody that was born became a lawyer. Like, how would we make food? There would be no farmers, right? There wouldn't be no growers, right? So we want to have a diversity of the microbes, and you know, that's what this product provides you, unlike some of the other mycorrhizae products out there. I mean, I don't want to talk forever at this booth because I have like 20 other booths to show you guys, but this is foundational, and don't even watch the rest of this video if you guys aren't even going to get like this product right here. You can learn more at plant-success.com. Now, this is their basically the cannabis line, and I have had this on my gardening show in the past, and there's other ones if you guys are into basically soil-based gardening. They have a gardening line that's totally different, so you have to check my other videos for that. But you know, I've used all their different products, and they're all great. So plant-success.com, available at better hydroponic stores near you. So the next exhibit I want to show you guys is actually Wormville worm castings made out of Tennessee here in the USA. And this is the only basically worm casting company here, although some of the other big companies may have worm castings at their booth. This is the only worm farm literally that's here at the show. And I wanted to share them with you guys because worm castings are an integral and important part of my grow and should be definitely in your grow as well. And let's learn more about why the Wormville castings are definitely a good buy. All right, so what you guys are looking at are the Wormganic worm castings right here. And definitely, while they got some good quality castings here from just looking at it and from the test data, I'm gonna say, honestly, their display definitely needs something to be desired. It's a table with a little box of this. And, but you know, here's the thing. You know, at this event, they're focused on selling basically pallet loads and container loads and tote loads to, you know, big growers. They're not focusing on retail sales, although they have a retail line. If you look it up, it's actually just Google Wormganic. You could get to them at wormcasting.com. So here's the thing, right? Wormville, right? What they do is they don't focus on making castings, actually. Their goal is to actually produce high quality worms for the fishing and other industries, right? And so to have healthy worms, right, you have to be feeding them a good diet. And if you're making and feeding healthy worms, they're reproducing more than not, so that they'll have a lots of you know, good healthy worms to sell, and big fat worms and juicy ones if you're a fish. But also that means they're gonna make a superior casting. The other thing they're doing, unlike some of the other worm facilities or worm casting places I've visited in the past, is that they have a very consistent constant feed, you know, and this could be a pro and it could be a con at the same time, because they basically feed only two ingredients. So that means every batch that comes out of their facility is pretty much going to be the same. And I know a lot of you guys that are commercial farmers, commercial egg, you guys want consistency, and that in some cases is hard to get in organics, but with their product, because they're only feeding the same two ingredients, right? A US sourced peat and also corn silage, non-GMO, it's always gonna be the same. And that's what I really like, the consistent product, right? And here it is right here, right? And you're noticing, like, I've seen a lot of crap worm castings on the market. So just because it says worm casting in the bag doesn't mean they're good worm castings, right? Much like anything in life. I mean, you could get the generic Coca-Cola or the Coke, right? That's garbage compared to like the name brand Coke. Maybe that's a bad analogy, but you guys get the picture, right? Homegrown tomatoes versus like store-bought pink tomatoes in the wintertime that bounce and have no flavor, right? The same product, but just way different in the quality, right? And that's where they literally have proven their system, their quality, and that their material coming out of the worm is actually the castings and not just basically compost that's been sitting in a pile and then basically being rebagged. Because, you know, there's a lot of shady stuff going on in the worm casting industry, in my personal opinion. You know, I've seen bags that I open up and it's like, these don't look like castings. And I see bags that look like all castings because they're like little turds. So while it's cool to get 100% castings, you know, the main benefit to getting a product like this, you're like, John, there's a lots of different husks and corn silage, little threads in there and like stuff. And like, that's not good. I want castings only. Well, here's what you don't, you know, is that when you get a little bit of the bedding material that was not broken down by the worms, that's the hardy stuff, right? That's the stuff where the fungi will attach, and now you're gonna get a better and more broad spectrum of some of the different microbes in the product, which to me, the worm castings are not about the NPK values. And that being said, this company's NPK values or N value is actually very stable. And that's also a good sign showing that they actually make a good consistent product across the board. It's actually 0.9 to not 0.9 or 1 on a consistent and regular basis when they test it. So, and they don't make any fertilizer claims on the label, right? To me, this is a microbial product that can add, you know, countless amounts of microbes, all right? So here's the thing, right? Better product because it's more of a whole food basis and isolate. And so I like that a lot. And then the other thing I want you guys to do is, if you're gonna go buy worm castings, ask the casting company, ask whoever's selling the castings, ask them for data testing. So in many cases, if you ask them for data testing, they're gonna give you a test like this, which is a standard lab analysis test or NPK test, which is common in the fertilizer industry. And to me, like, you know, these are not that important of a number. It's like, I'm actually gonna throw those out. You really don't even want that test. That's not the test we should be looking for. I mean, they might have other tests, you know, that have other different minerals on there, you know, calcium, magnesium, potassium, which are all in desired ranges for these castings right here. We don't really want to look at that test either, because to me, the power of the worm castings are the biology in the worm castings. And so you want to get something like this test, a food soil web test. This is by Earth Fort. And this basically will tell you the total active fungi and total fungi, the hyphae diameter, as well as the bacteria. So if we look at this chart here, and you guys probably can't see that too clearly on the camera because it's small, but anyways, I'm reading it off. Active fungi is 24, and the desired level is above 3. So that's like significantly above the desired level. And then the total fungi is 2,042.3, and the desired level is above 300. So that's significantly higher. Now, you know, I would have to see other worm casting tests to know if this is like good or not, because maybe some will be higher, some will be lower. But here's the thing, right? We don't want to just look at the number. We want to look at the variety and species of the bacteria or fungi, and based on the worms, where they're located in the world, based on what the worms are eating, it's all going to be different. So you can't say this casting is always better than that one. So I would encourage you guys, and what I do is I get multiple types of casting, mix them all together so I have the best biology of them all, and then put those into my garden, all right? And then the active bacteria is 297.51, and it's supposed to be, once again, above 3.0, and the total, that's active bacteria, and the total bacteria is 902.76, and it should be above 300. So these castings definitely meet my test. I guess to know more, I have to start using them and trialing them out. You know, castings can be quite valuable in your garden. You know, you could top dress them in, you could add them to like your soil blend when you mix up your soil, and actually they should be a pretty good percentage, in my opinion, 10% if you guys could get away with it, at least. You can also make compost tea out of it to spread that biology through your garden. I mean, so many ways to use it, and the one thing I will say is that you do want to use them. If you want to learn more about the Worm Organic and the Wormville, and maybe one day I'll get out to Tennessee because they did invite me to the factory to make a tour, you can check them out at wormcasting.com. And if you guys want to buy this stuff online because it may be available at better nurseries near you or hydro stores, you could Google Wormganic, which is their packaged product. Now, keep in mind also, this company private label, so like they'll sell this brand, these worm castings, under multiple different brands, and I don't know all the brands out there, so you have to contact them to learn more about that, if they will release that information to you, if you guys want to get some of these amazing castings. All right, so the next exhibitor I want to show you, the guys, is actually BioTherm, and they do lots of things, like mostly having to do with greenhouses and big scale stuff, but they got a really cool device that I want to show you guys that you probably never seen before. You guys probably might think it's hokey, but this stuff is legit, right? In another area of this whole exhibitors, there's like another exhibitor basically doing something very similar with basically infuse oxygen or water to raise the PPMs of the oxygen, but their machine is like thousands of dollars, right? This one is really cheap, even affordable for home growers like me, or you home cannabis growers, or just small farmers that want to increase your oxygen level in the water to prevent a lot of problems, and more importantly, increase your plant growth. So let's learn about it. All right, so what you guys are looking at is a tube setup, and this is a dual tube setup, right? You may not have to get the dual tube setup. It depends on how much water is flowing through your system. Like for me, I would just get a single tube system that actually I'm sitting on in the boxes right now. And I'm not gonna mention prices, but check their website. I think it's around like $16.99. They got a show special that I'm not gonna disclose for you guys since you're not here. But basically, what this does is through these tubes, they pump in oxygen from an oxygen tank, very important. So that's a consumable you will have to buy unless you buy an oxygen concentrator that you could buy, you know, for several thousand dollars and make your own oxygen. And then basically the oxygen goes in these pipings and then into this little tube here, and basically it forces oxygen at a higher level into the water. And how it works is like this. This is the clear version, so it's kind of cool. This is not a filtration device, basically. This is like a ballast. Like think of a balloon, right? So this is a balloon that the compressed oxygen goes into in high concentrations. It fills up the hole, it fills up the balloon, and as the water goes through, there's micropores in the balloon, so it lets the oxygen go into the water so that it raises your oxygen level in the water. So like if you take tap water out of the tap, the PPM of the oxygen may be like between 6 and 9, depending on where you live and other factors, right? And that's pretty low, and you know, people just growing that stuff all the time, it does pretty well. But here, if you pump in the oxygen, you can see on this little meter, and this is a fancy meter, you can get cheap meters and stuff, but on this fancy meter, they got the water in this, after going through the system, at 26 ppm. Now, you don't want to get too high oxygen, more is not necessarily better, but for plants and even for fish, they say maybe around 20 is the target where you want to get to. Maybe it might be a little bit less, maybe it might be a little bit more, but here's the thing, if you have this system, you can control how much oxygen is flowing in the system so that you can get the dissolved oxygen that you want, you know. And it said like if you have higher dissolved oxygen in like a hydro system where you're recirculating the water, right, you're not gonna get the mold or the algae buildups because oxygen is an oxidizer, right? The other thing for me personally growing in soil, right, oxygen is critical for basically the plant health and more importantly the bacteria and microbial life in the soil. So when you're increasing the oxygen there, you're basically gonna increase the plant's respiration as well as the bacteria and the fungi's respiration as well, and just make the whole system work better. When the whole system work better, what happens? Terpenes go up, cannabinoids go up, yields go up, vitamins and minerals go up. All these things go up because the plant's healthier, right? If you're healthy, right, and you're not undernourished like I am today because I haven't eaten enough today because I've been freaking filming this video all day and I barely had breakfast, you know, then you're on point, you're gonna do a lot better. So if you guys wanna learn more about the tube, the oxygen infuser that I like so much, and maybe hopefully one of these days I'll get, you can learn more about them at BioThermSolutions.com. So to me, aside from the microbes that I just showed you guys about, the minerals are also the kingpins and how you can increase your plant growth and literally your success in growing. Now we're gonna talk to you guys about the BioAg products here, and check out that picture there, Bio Program. Our results speak for themselves. Look at that guy. See that leaf he's holding? That's a single cannabis leaf. And I guess they use the full power products, you know, to basically get a super huge cannabis. Hey, if you guys are getting that big of huge cannabis leaves, well, you can grow charred leaves that big, you can grow kale leaves that big, right? And then think about the buds. How big are the buds gonna be if the cannabis leaf is that big? So anyways, let's learn more about the BioAg product. So now I wanna show you guys actually some products that they have here at BioAg that I believe you guys should be using. And basically it's, you know, soil humates are critical. I add them in their whole form into my garden beds. And you could do this if you're growing in garden beds. If you're doing a hydro system, then you're gonna have to put like a soluble version. I always encourage you guys to use like solid products instead of liquid products. Generally, it's going to be a better value for you guys. So we're going to go over some of their products real quick here. So the full humus is basically a water-soluble humic acid that they've broken down, and that's really great. But, you know, they take their product and make it even better. And this is very important. They have the TM7, so they basically have their humic, which helps increase absorption of nutrients into your plants. And then they add trace minerals, you know, such as some that can be deficient, like such as boron, cobalt, that's responsible for making like that B12, right? Maybe deficient soils. So they have this right here. And then to take it to the next level, basically they have the humic plus the minerals plus the plant cytokines from kelp in here. So this is like the one product I'm going to recommend, because you can buy all their stuff. But if you want to just get one, get this. And of course, to go along with this, as I already talked about, they have their own mycorrhizal product, the VAM. But you know, so here my favorite product at BioAg is actually the Cyto Plus, the water soluble humates with the extra trace minerals, as well as the seaweed extract. And this is the product that, in my opinion, y'all should be using. Want to learn more? Check them out at bioag.com. All right, so the next exhibitor I want to show you guys, actually there's two in one, twofer, and it's Happy Tree Microbes and Dynasty Genetics and Relic Seeds, that has some seeds that you may want to get so you could grow your own. All right, so now I want to show you guys this stuff right here. This is the Harmonic Tonic, right? So if this ain't hippie, I don't know what is. If you guys are like straight line growers, you might want to steer clear. But if you're into like maybe increasing your yields, getting higher terpenes and higher cannabinoids, this is the product you guys are going to want to get, because there's nothing like it on the market at this time. Basically, while they do have some of the different microbes labeled, there's things like, you know, mycorrhizae and beneficial bacteria in here. And here's the thing, right? Unlike the other product I showed you so far that has maybe a handful or a dozen different beneficials, right? This has over 1,000 as evidenced by DNA sequencing on it. Now, they can't tell if they're alive or dead in the DNA stuff, but having over 1,000, because this is not a man-made product in a lab like many mycorrhizal or bacteria inoculants can be. This is actually made from the poop or the shit of lactating cows, right? And when cows are lactating, there's more lactobacillus, right? That's how they make yogurt, right? In the cow's milk, which is also in the cow system, which is then said to come out into the cow's poop. So there's basically rich colonies of microorganisms that they basically take and then they purify, so that if you open this stuff up, it doesn't smell like cow poop. I mean, it doesn't smell like anything. It smells like water. So, but basically what you're looking at is this is an inoculant. So then you're gonna, you know, just measure out a little bit, measured in the water, and then introduce it into your system, whatever system you guys are growing. Now, it doesn't even stop there, right? They take the initial product and they make it better by bioenhancing it, if you wanna call bioenhancing whatever, you know. And this may be some hokey dokey stuff, but you know, here's the thing, right? Even if it's hokey dokey and you never believed in this stuff before, like, it's not gonna hurt the product. And I believe it's only gonna make it better, especially one of the ingredients I know it's gonna make it better. So this is what they do. They basically take some kind of gemstones, right? And like gemstone infuse this product. I don't know. I don't think it could hurt, and it could only help. And there's power in gems and stones and basically minerals, right? This is known in a lot of the healing arts. Next, they basically take rare Amazonian herbs. Or herbs. Hey, what's up, herb? And then they've infused that in here too, right? So they're literally like just making a whole concoction brew that they found in synergy works amazing. And here's the other thing they do, right? Fulvic acid. This stuff is proven working. This is not hocus pocus stuff like the gemstones. It's proven that, you know, if you add fulvic acid to things, right, there's better uptake, right? Your plants will get better uptakes of nutrients. So this stuff's legit. So, you know, I've seen this and it's like, oh, and here's the thing. Proof is in the pudding, right? Does this stuff work? Am I just shouting out my butt, right? Because it seems cool and I like microbial products. Well, yes, I do like microbial products. But here's the thing. You know, they've done studies and testing in Japan in here. I'm not going to read the whole thing, but basically, I'll read the results. In cultivar number 3, Crazy Train, THC increased from 13.8 to 18.1, a 31% increase. So if you want to increase your terpenes or cannabinoids, oh here, total cannabinoids increased from 15.8 to 20.2, right? Why? Why does this happen? Well, when the plant is healthier, it produces more of those things that you guys want. And here's the thing, right? They even got testing, side-by-side testing. Now, this is not like scientific or anything, but basically they gave this stuff to the grower, and the grower grew the same exact plant from the same clones at the same exact time, and they basically grew sugar, black rose, and the cannabinoids on this one without the product use, right, was 18% total THC. And then over here, the sugar, black rose, same thing, same plant, same age, but using the product here, right? Went up 2 points, right? 20.1%, right? I mean, and there's other pages here that show increases in terpenes, right? And this is the power of basically adding the microbes and the wide spectrum of microbes. And I'm never gonna say like, you gotta use this microbe or that microbe, right? I don't know what microbe the plant wants, right? So that's what I say is, put as many as you guys can in there and let the microbes figure it out once it's in the soil. So that's basically it for this stuff. You can learn more about them at the happytreemicrobes.com. So also the Happy Tree Microbes are sharing a booth with this company here. And you know, I was here yesterday when they were here, and this is basically Dynasty Genetics, and they're at dynastyseeds.com. So Dynasty Seeds have been working on saving like old fashioned, like, you know, heirloom style cannabis seeds from the olden days, you know, and they also have CBD varieties with different ratios of CBD. So you might want to check them out for your seeds. And here's the thing, right, on seeds, even seeds that grow the technically, it's legal to own the seeds as far as I'm aware, but of course, before you buy any seeds, check out online, because the seeds don't contain any in there, but the minute you germinate them, then that's where it gets into potentially being illegal. And I think we're gonna have another major seed seller actually in this video in just a little bit. All right, so the next exhibit I wanna show you guys is actually Marone BioInnovations, and they basically have biologic pest controls actually. And this is the kind of pest controls I want you guys to use besides like beneficial insects. The biologic controls, like basically pests can basically evolve out of the biologic controls because that's like what's built into nature. So let's learn more about them. All right, so I wanna show you guys this picture here. So this is untreated control, and this is a Regalia biofungicide applied. Look at the difference between these plants. What's healthier, right? And the other cool thing about all the products here, they're all OMRI certified organic, right? So if you're gonna try to have an organic grow, these are them. I mean, it makes me sad in the cannabis and even in farming industries that they're using so many synthetic pesticides and fungicides and herbicides that are toxic, not only to, you know, the bugs, but also to us as well as the planet, right? These things are gonna be good for the planet, and you know, it's just the best way to go. And check this out. So if you guys are here, you guys could pick up one of these guys, and this is a pest guide, right? They talk about how you deal with aphids, thrips, broad mites and russet mites, spider mites, boitrus, bud rot, and powdery mildew, right? Using their products, right? But here's the thing, right? Those you guys that don't grow cannabis, you can substitute in lettuce pest guide or broccoli pest guide, because it don't matter. Whatever the pest is, they're gonna be controlled the same way with the exact same products. And actually the products here are coming from the big ag industry that they've been using in organic fields for like, I don't even know, like dozens and dozens of years. So let's learn more about them. All right, so here are the three products that I'm gonna share with you guys today. It's the Regalia, Grandivo, and Venturate. And this is a biofungicide, bioinsecticide, and bioinsecticide here. So the Regalia is good against like powdery mildew, pythium rot, and boitrus. The main thing, if you guys are growing cannabis or hemp, or growing indoors like greenhouse culture, you wanna make sure you guys get the CG version of this. That's the one approved for the greenhouse and the cannabis and the hemp markets, whereas they have regular versions that may be available at big farm stores, but these are not approved for the, you know, specific crops or indoors that you guys are growing, right? And the other thing is the Grandview, that's for pests like mites, thrips, and aphids. And then the Venturate is good for mites, thrips, and aphids. And basically how these things work, I mean, we'll pick up the bottle of Regalia. This is a very popular product, right? At the organic agriculture conference I go to, I mean, they talk about this stuff here. So basically this stuff is a plant extract that basically, it's like if we eat like a certain food, like if you eat a lot of carrots, right, your skin is gonna turn orange, right? And that's because we eat carrots, our skin turns orange, and if you give this to the plants, basically it turns on the SAR, does some crazy stuff, and then the plant starts making defense mechanisms to get resist the pests, like the powdery mildew, pythium rot, and boitrous. Now, some of these products actually contain basically killed microbes in there. So even killed microbes can have a positive effect on your plants. So these ones will basically, the killed microbes are effective against thrips, mites, and aphids. So yeah, that's the Grand Diva. So I want to learn more about these things because normally these are found in big ag, so now they're going to be available, you know, for like cannabis growers and hemp growers and more small agriculture in a, you know, smaller size, because normally these things are sold in truckloads, tank loads, and at least minimum 5 gallons. So I'm glad to see them in like, you know, quart sizes now. If you want to learn more, you can check them out at maronebio.com. All right, so the next exhibitor I want to show you guys is actually A&P Health, Inc. And what they do is they basically make a tox detective. So you guys have ever wondered if the you guys are buying is clean, or the stuff you're producing is clean, or if even fruits and vegetables that you got by the store is clean and free of like really hardcore harmful, you know, pesticides, residues, and all these kind of things, right? This product was basically developed for the military so the military could determine if things are contaminated or not. And like, so like this is like military grade, the military funded all this stuff. But now it's available in a commercial version and then also a home test kit version that you guys could all use. So let's learn more about it. All right, so this is the Tox Detective. This is the deluxe version, right? This is military grade, military version. This is the same ones that the military has like in their kits or in warehouses or who knows where in Iraq or wherever they are in the world, right? Totally military case. It's basically a built-in computer with a special reader in there, a special camera reader that could basically do the testing to determine if you have different toxins. So here's the thing, this is the Tox Detective, and inside here it says, test for over 70 of the most common pesticides and toxins used found in and hemp, as well as, you know, fruits and vegetables and other edible plant foods, right?
Absolutely.
And this is based on award-winning military technology tested and validated by the U.S. Army and the EPA itself. So, and it's super simple, super easy to use. Once again, this setup is 15 grand. I don't know if most of you guys would be buying that for your home use. But the cool thing is they have the home version right here, which is not quite as sophisticated. So this detects organophosphates and carbamates, which are basically two classes of like pesticides that are extremely bad and toxic. Like it's not gonna detect any pesticide. Like I sprayed neem oil, probably not gonna detect that because that's like more natural. So this is only for like the really bad stuff and the stuff that you don't wanna be smoking or ingesting in your body, in my opinion. So how this works is basically they have these little sample things that all is an enzymatic reaction that they develop the right enzymes that basically degrade those particular toxins, and then it basically changes the color on these test kits. So on the professional unit, basically there's two tests, and there's an A side and a B side. One side is always a control side, so you could see if there's no toxins in there, what it's gonna look like, and if there is the toxins present, what it's gonna look like. So basically you do this test, you let it sit for 15 minutes. If there's toxins in there, the color changes, and this is all fluorescent, so you can't see with the human eye, but this special reader could read that, and you guys could see the A and the B side, so you guys could see the difference, and it'll tell you if toxins are detected or not, right?
Right.
So then going for the home version, right? Home version, a lot more simpler. You don't have a control, so it still can be accurate, but now it's more up to you. If you ever did like one of those chlorine tests in your pool, you put the sticker in, you pull it out, and it's like you look at the color here and you compare the color there. That's pretty much what you're gonna do on this. You test the A and the B side for different classes of the toxins, and then you're gonna look at it and then see if it's like if it's a hit or not. So this may be problematic for certain things like, you know, that have anthocyanin pigments, which are the purple pigments in food. So testing purple carrots probably not gonna be good because the purple carrots are just gonna stain this anyways. So like testing clear things will be very important. So to do this test, it's quite easy, and you know, I always like to make sure that companies stay honest. So what I bought today is, I bought actually some kale greens picked from my garden, and I don't spray nothing. Well, I don't spray anything, any toxics that should come on here. I think I might have sprayed these with some kind of enzyme, Dr. Zyme's enzyme product, and these were definitely not sprayed at least for 6 months or a year with any kind of neem or Dr. Bronner's, which should not set this test off, right? So if you're using organics, probably not gonna set the test off. But then also I brought, to keep them honest, I brought some organic CBD hemp that's basically free. That when I bought it, they said it was organic, but I don't really know. So how this is gonna work, we're gonna take a sample of a product and put it in a little plastic bag with water because we need to get a dilution. And so we're gonna get all the things out from the test material into the water. And then you're just gonna put a drop of water on this and then basically wait 12 minutes and come back. So we're gonna go ahead and test these things off camera and we're gonna come back at you with the results. All right, so now we're back at the booth that did the testing on my industrial hemp that is claimed to be organic, and also my backyard grown stuff that I know I didn't spray unless somebody's sneaking in there and spraying stuff, or their machine ain't working. So let's see what happened, all right? So, you know, once again, they're a $15,000 unit. I mean, this is pretty much gonna be solid. And so this is the results. Takes a picture. So this is like the control. You can see there's like no blow up in the control. And in the one where they tested the industrial hemp I bought, is totally blown up, man. It's full of toxins, man. I'm eating this stuff. This really sucks. Like, what do I do with this crap now, right? So they had an A side and a B side, right? One checks for organophosphate based, pesticides and chemicals. And there's like the other kind that you got to go back to. But the other one also negative too. So that's these black ones. They did a control, non-control. And then the home version, that also detected that the hemp stuff I bought also highly, highly toxic actually, and had contamination in there. So man, I don't know what I'm gonna do with this stuff, and I can't recommend the company I bought this stuff from anymore. Anyways, all right. Now, to make sure they're staying honest and to make sure nobody's spraying my stuff at home, right, we could go back. It's just that one. Yep. And as you guys can see, my leaves were negative, right? You could see the control there, it's nice and bright, and mine is nice and bright too because there weren't the toxins in there that activated the enzymes that made the color change and phosphoresce, right? Once again, these are the tests for that they ran in this machine, and here's that home version test that they also ran. And if you let this sit too long, then the reading is no longer valid, so they did take a picture showing me that my stuff blew clean, and basically it's just my collard greens out of my garden that they basically put water in to kind of dissolve any kind of toxins into the water, which then they test the water, and that's what happens. So if you guys want to learn more about this device, get your own at-home test kits for $25 so you can learn if your stuff is contaminated or not. You can visit them at toxdetective.com. Next exhibit I want to show you guys is actually the blue mat watering systems, and this basically is a solution to all your irrigation needs so you never overwater or underwater again. All right, so now I want to show you guys more about the blue mat watering systems, and if you guys live in like Europe, you'll be more familiar with this because it's been out in Europe for like 30 or 40 years, and a lot of home gardeners use the blue mat technology over there. So this is like old school technology. It's not some newfangled thing, right? And here's the thing, you know, I have a problem in my garden. The problem is watering, right? Most people, including me, I'm guilty of this too, either overwater or underwater their plants, right? Yeah. Which one's better, overwatering or underwatering? They're both bad, right? You underwater, starving your plants of nutrients, you're overwatering, you're flooding them out, you're starving them in nutrients also, they can't breathe, not good. You want to get the watering just right, right? And especially in my arid climate, I tend to overwater than underwater, because I mean, it's probably better to err on the side of caution, but then it depends on the plant, right? Overwatering basil, definitely not a good thing. Basil does not like its feet being wet. And you would think that in 2019 now, maybe you guys are watching this in 2020, they'd have some kind of plant sensor probe, like computer digital that connects to your phone, that could turn off a valve on or off to make sure that your plants only get water when it needs to. Now that's a high-tech solution for a low-tech problem, and I'm glad to say we don't need that solution because we have the blue tech. Once again, this is invented like 30 to 40 years ago here in Europe, and this is just very simple, right? No computers, no iPhone necessary. This device, this amazing device I hold in my hand, will basically control the flow of your water depending if it's wet or not in the area where this is plugged. So this is like a moisture sensor plus water valve in one, right? Old fashioned, it's not gonna go bad, or the batteries are never gonna go out in this guy, right? So that is totally amazing. And how this works is basically, this is like a ceramic, right? And you know, you may think oil, so like the water comes out of this, and you know, on most of the models, the water does not come out of the bottom, it's just used as a probe. And if the moisture comes in, then basically this senses some kind of osmotic pressure or something, and then lets the water flow through the valve. And then also they have the ones for the potted plants, which the water does come out of this when it is dry, which you can hook up to gravity systems. So these systems need 100% constant water pressure 24/7 to work. You know, I don't know that I'd hook it up into my like into my home, you know, well or anything like that, because that's a pressurized water and then it could just, you know, flow out and you could have some pretty bad leaks. But the cool thing is you could set it up with a 5 gallon bucket that you can partially see here, or an IBC tote. So if you're off the grid, this is literally the solution you need to make sure you get proper watering each and every time. So I kind of gave you the pitch, but now we're going to show actual functional use of how this would work in a raised bed system, because that's how I grow. Of course, you could also use this with container plants, or, you know, they're now installing big commercial cannabis grows using the same technology. All right, so this looks pretty complicated. I'm going to go ahead and try to lay it out for you, right? So the 5 gallon bucket full of water here, and it comes down to this feed tube line, right? This feed tube line is right here. I'm holding it all in my hands, right? So this is constant pressure water. The constant pressure water goes into two probes. This probe here, right? These probes basically act as a valve. It turns the water flow off or on depending if the moisture sensor at the bottom is wet or dry. To make this work properly, you need to pre-fill these and get the proper moisture levels first, or it's not gonna work properly. You can't just hook it all up and then have it work. You gotta get basically kind of condition them to your soil. And then if these become dry, then it's like, oh, I'm dry, then it lets this flow come through this other side, which then goes to all this other piping that then will distribute the water, and actually it's quite wet in here, to the rest of the bed. So, I mean, that's the simple technology and how it works, literally, by just using this as the moisture sensor and valve at the same exact time. Once again, nothing to break. You could probably take this guy apart and, you know, clean it out if any of the passageways get clogged up, and that's probably the biggest problem that you might have with this guy. I mean, in addition, they got these guys up top, and these guys, while they may look the same as this one here that does not water out of the bottom, right? This is only the valve. These guys here actually let the water flow out the bottom, so you guys can see the pot here on a potted plant. You guys can basically run constant pressure with a 5 gallon bucket to one of these guys, and when it's dry, your plant will get water, and when it's wet, it won't get any water. So yeah, blue mat stuff, really super amazing. If you want to learn more, you can check them out for the US distributor at sustainablevillage.com. The next vendor I want to show you guys is actually Arbico Organics, and they have an amazing display of organic products that help you guys grow any kind of fruit, vegetable, herb, nut, or seed organically. So let's learn about it. All right, so I'll say this about Arbico. They got some of the best top shelf good products that actually I use and recommend myself, including the EM1 and some of the different, the Dipel. I use that myself for like the cabbage moss. I use, you know, different kinds of like neem and pyrethrins and the Pure Crop. I got some of that stuff. I mean, oh, they got the Regalia Grandivo that I talked to you guys about a little bit earlier. So this is the place you guys want to buy them. They got my favorite, the Dr. Zahn. I mean, this place knows what's up. If you're looking for some kind of organic control, right? Arbico probably got it for you guys. But I'm really not going to focus on that here today, because although organic controls are very important for me and organic nutrients are very important for me also, right? The reason why I'm here is because they have a whole a section of display that I'm not showing you yet. And to me, that should be your first level of biologic control in your garden, which is basically beneficial insects, predatory insects that will actually eat the bad guys in your garden, so that you don't have to spray anything on your garden to deal with them. And especially in a greenhouse situation or enclosed environment, I mean, it's a no-brainer to do the beneficials. All right, so what you guys are seeing behind me are some of the different predators that Arbico sells to help you guys control different outbreaks. So I know a big problem that a lot of you guys may have is fungus gnats. John, what do I do for fungus gnats? Well, conventional agriculture may just kill the whole soil and kill everything in the soil, including the fungus gnats. To me, that's not the way to do it. You're killing all your microbes and bacteria. The way to do it would be something like this. Fungus gnat predators, right? You put this stuff out of your garden, these guys eat fungal, basically the fungus gnats for breakfast, right? And lunch and dinner. So they'll eat up and basically take your problem away, right? They have other controls like mite predators. You got mites, right? And make sure you get the right mite predator for the exact mite you have, and you can call them up to ask them questions. And you can basically, the mite predators will basically be your workforce for you, so that you don't have to take care of them, right? They're free. Once you buy these guys, you own them, you can put them out in your garden, and they basically are just literally programmed to eat their target pest, basically, or their food, right? Here's another mite predator, and this is how they kind of come in here. They have green lacewing eggs, which are in here. If you want the little eggs, like, I think the better way to get them is like this, where they'll basically hatch. The lacewings are a good all-purpose predator that'll eat like aphids and whiteflies and things. Actually, I like to use those in my garden. I mean, even better yet, and I get these guys every year, I get praying mantis eggs that I put out in my garden. I do 3 releases during the summer season. These guys only live when it's warm, and I release these guys, and they basically will eat, like, they've been eating my cabbage moss and tomato hornworm so that I have very few of those problems anymore. Now these guys only, the praying mantis only like to eat them. Those guys, when they're really small and they get really big, the praying mantises aren't gonna eat them. They have things for like thrips and white flies, and they have a whole selection of different beneficial bugs, including ladybugs that are kind of flying around the booth here. So you guys can see in here, you can see all the little spots. I mean, these are the beneficials that are gonna basically attack and eat the bad guys. I wish I could get more into this for you guys, maybe in an upcoming episode, but like I really wanted you guys to get into like more of this integrative pest management techniques where you're basically releasing the beneficials to control for you, and even don't release them reactively. Like I have an outbreak, I need to release some beneficials. Actually at that point, in some cases, actually too late. You wanna release these guys ahead of time before you get the outbreak so that they're in your garden first. And if there's an outbreak that should occur, the good guys are already there to beat the bad guys. It's like, you know, you're watching one of those cops and robbers shows, right? If the police know where the robbers are gonna rob, what bank they're gonna be, they could be waiting outside. So the robbers come, boom, they're gone. And same thing, you wanna get those beneficials in your garden now to ensure that you're not gonna have those outbreaks when that happens. So if you wanna learn more about Arabico, you can check them out at arabico-organics.com. Link is down below the video for all the exhibitors and vendors that I've covered in this episode. Next exhibit I want to show you guys is actually grassroots. They started with some actually living soil fabric pots, and then also they're just getting into now the new concentrated biology. And if you guys are looking for like the one product that John likes the most at this whole event, right, it's the product right there on the table. I literally spent an hour and a half here, or maybe an hour and a half, talking to the inventor of the product, and I'm gonna be sharing with you guys, and hopefully I do it justice. But I mean, this is literally the game changer product that you guys have all been looking for. So let's learn more about the living soil beds and this amazing biologic product. All right, so Grassroots' claim to fame is that they make basically fabric beds. And you know, I first literally walked by this exhibitor because I was like, oh, fabric pots, I don't need fabric pots. I kept walking. And then I saw like some stuff on a table that was labeled like compost tea. And I'm like, ah, compost tea in a jug, that stuff's no good. And I kept walking until the guy that was actually working here was like, John, and he knew me because he watches me. So then I came back and like, well, hey, what do you do here? Then he explained it. And I'm like, oh my God, thanks for calling me because I'm so glad I came back. So anyways, his fabric pot's a little bit different than a lot of them out there. And actually I'm gonna do some trials with this. So as you guys know, the fabric pots are good because they do root pruning, or they say they do root pruning. The challenge with that is that the water will seep out the sides, and I've noticed, especially in my arid climate, that you know, just an inch or two in from the side wall, it's completely dry because the water is really sucked out of the air here. But inside these guys, they basically have a waterproof lining here so that the water is directed down to the plant roots so that you don't get the dry spots. That could be good, right? The other thing is I have my fabric pots against a concrete block wall that if it leaches out the back, the water will get on the concrete block wall, and then that basically degrades the concrete. So, you know, they have these beds here with the liner as well so that the water does not come out. So, you know, you can direct the water where you need it. So I like that a lot. And then, the other claim of fame is that while they do have stock sizes, they can make you guys any size you need. So that's the part I really like. It's completely customizable with an only, I think, $200 minimum order. And if you order $250, you get free shipping. So you get the exact size, width, dimensions, and heights, and all this stuff of the exact, you know, circular or even square bed that you need. All right, so now I want to show you guys this amazing product that I learned about here. It's actually called the Grassroots, and it's called the Metagrow ST. And what this is literally concentrated microbes, right? I think the sign they should have on their booth, it says, got 20,000 microbes. So literally that's what's been proven in this product, over 20,000 different kinds of microbes in this compost tea that they brewed, that they basically put the microbes to sleep four or five different ways so that it can be stable for up to a year. So check this out. It says microbial concentration 20,000 species 1 times 10 to the 10th power, you know, Bacillus lichenformis, Bacillus subtilis, Microconidus luteus. Anyways, penicillin, there's a penicillin in there. Totally crazy. And it says a microbial inoculant, soil and plant probiotics, stable microbes with 1 year shelf life, reduces the frequency and severity of plant diseases. Never any simple sugars or manure. So that's, I'll have to talk to you guys about that. Microscope verified DNA sequence directed biology, increased bricks and improved sugar to acid ratio and flavor profile, beneficial bacteria, fungi, and protozoa. So I mean, this product is badass. So I talked to the creator of this, and here's the thing, right? This product is not a new product in the world, right? This has been used for 7 to 8 years in the farming industry. First time it's now coming into the home gardener market, or for the industry here through grassroots here, right? And so this has literally 7 to 8 years of research, technology, and proof behind the pudding, literally, right? And so, like, I'm gonna try to sum this up in an hour and a half conversation. It's gonna be hard to do it in like 5 minutes because I gotta film like about 10 more places in this video, and I'm not gonna get to them all. So this is just concentrated microbes, and this is harvested from nature, not any kind of laboratory. So what they do, they went around the world and collected soil samples from different places around the world, right? So now they have a diverse collection of microbes. They then take that mixture and then they mix it with compost that they make on site, addition other compost that they bring in. So now they have a wider selection of microbes. In addition, the next level is they basically make worm castings. So they just don't have one worm casting pile, like I showed you some worm castings earlier. They have 4 to 5 different piles of worms, and they feed the worms. Each pile gets them, each gets fed something a little bit different, right? And some of the feeds are similar to some of these additions that you could have that work in addition to the Mega Grow ST. These are basically the activators or the food for the microbes, right? Microbes are basically will shift, like, right? Depending on the crowd they hang out with. So, I mean, if you're like kid hangs out with like the good crowd, the goody two shoes crowd, the smart kids, right? Kid more likely to be smart, right? If your kid's hanging out with the people that are, you know, doing crime and breaking in things, your kid's more likely to be into crime. But bacteria are like that too, right? Depending on who they hang out with, they could go good or bad, and, you know, depending on what they eat. So just like us, right? If we eat a junk food diet, you're gonna be crazy. There's a book called The Crazy Makers, talks about how junk food literally makes you crazy in the head. So get off that junk food, stop eating the processed food, the fast food, get on whole plant food diet, and whole foods, eating real foods, right? So anyways, these packets basically have different kinds of foods that will stimulate growth or create certain reactions or literally metabolites from the bacteria to get certain results. So for example, they have a high chitin recipe here. The high chitin recipe, basically what it does is basically makes your plants more disease resistant, right? They also have a recipe that they feed their earthworms like more cellulose, right? That then there's more cellulose degraders in those earthworm castings. They also feed some of their worms like glucans. The glucans will create different metabolites in the bacteria as well. So they basically combine all these different earthworm castings, put them into the one mixture, and then they brew this stuff up. So, you know, it's a little bit hard to talk here because it's loud at the booth. I wish I could go on and on and on and tell you guys this, about this stuff more, but hopefully I have a future episode on this. But trust me, this is the best stuff I found here, and I could go on forever, but I got to film a lot of other booths. So if you guys want to learn more about this stuff, you can check them out at grassrootsfabricpots.com. All right, the next exhibitor I want to show you guys today is actually the root maker, and this pot literally can change your life. Well, maybe not your life, but it'll change your plant's life for sure. So let's learn about it. So check it out, like the root maker system and the pots. These are not new, right? These are developed back in 1968. This is like the original, basically, self-pruning pot. I mean, they have all those like fabric pots, and these days they say do root pruning. I don't know if I buy that so much because the original root pots basically provide more air to the plant, and when the roots run into air, it stops, and basically they divide and they don't want to go any further, and they won't wrap around like in common pots would. So you get stronger root systems, and when you get stronger root systems, guess what happened? You have a stronger plant, a healthier plant, a plant that's more likely to produce, you know, richer, more tasting, better terpene rich, you know, fruits or vegetables or herbs or whatever you're growing, right? So yeah, 1968. Another sign, improve your yield potential with the root maker growing system. So they have a whole system. I mean, you might think the root maker pot is like, yeah, John, these are the root maker pots. Well, hey, there's another company in here selling something very similar to this, and I'm here at Root Maker, not the other company, showing you guys their stuff, because this is like the original. And besides just these pots, they have other pots that are also guaranteed root pruning for you guys. And I like these ones because they have like a removable bottom on the bottom. Anyways, this is how it works. You pot your plant up in here, and say you like growing trees on a patio and you're gonna transplant them out later, this is probably the best pot you wanna use, because number one, it comes apart very easily. You could reuse this, and to unfurl it, you just clip this zip tie, it comes out. You can basically have your root ball really easy without disturbing it, and potting it in. You know, I've even broken ceramic pots before that I could not get apart because the plant inside it was worth more than the pot, and if I just tried to like lift it up, I would be damaging the plant itself. So this will not do that. In addition, this will do that root pruning that you guys want to have the most and strongest root system. So this is like probably like one of the original pots, and they've made it even better. Aside from big ones, they have smaller ones too. If you guys want a blow molded, this is their root pruning pot. You know, instead of like the hardcore one, this is like the more normal looking one. But this is root pruning too, and how it works is they got the holes in the bottom and then holes at every level. And it's not straight and flat. It's kind of like stepped. So that's the secret is in the sauce. And I'm sure they have a patent on this. Now, so probably the most important time that you guys want to make sure your plants are root pruned is when you start them out as little seedlings, right? I mean, the health of the seedling when it's young is very important. Like if you have a regular human baby or a dog baby, whatever kind of cat baby, whatever babies you guys are into, right? The healthier you could have the baby when they're young, the healthier the adult plant will be, or you know, the adult kid will be in the case of kids, right? So very important to use something like this. This is the basically for starting seeds. And as you guys can see, this is not like your normal seed starting. This actually has a really cool like pattern in there that's jagged. Number one, this allows for easy evacuation of your seedlings, but more importantly, it provides root pruning at the time it's most critical, when the roots are being formed from the get-go. So once you get root pruned here and then you put them in the garden or in soil or the next size pot up, right, they're already gonna be on their way to having better health than ever, right? And grow and produce more. They just announced that this place is closing down, so I wish I could spend more time here, but I gotta visit a couple more booths. And then for the booths I can't visit, I'm gonna share with you guys what I would have shared that I wasn't able to. So if you guys wanna learn more about these guys, the website is rootmaker.com. So the next exhibitor I'm gonna share with you guys is actually the Purple Pro, and it's a game changer, right? If you guys are growing industrial hemp, right? This device allows you to tell your potency on the spot, like instantly, of flower only. Won't let you use kind of extracts. They may have some kind of like future updates to be able to do that. And so what I brought today was my own stuff. Well, I didn't grow this stuff, but I bought this stuff. So this is like sourced from Oregon. It's industrial hemp, should have like basically below 0.3, but should contain, I think it's supposed to be about 16% CBD, 13 to 16% if my memory's right, of what's in here. And so their device that basically integrates to your cell phone will tell you how much and CBD in there, and they will be adding features in the future so that you can read other cannabinoids, even moisture content as well. And I think the machine's about $1,500, so let's put some of this in there and see what the results are. All right, so now I'm gonna show you guys actually how this Purple Pro works. It's super simple, super easy, and you can probably do it when you're stoned, although you shouldn't be doing it when you're stoned, all right? So number one, you need a cell phone with the app downloaded onto there, and this is all set up. The next thing is you're gonna need the Purple Pro. It's like a near-infrared microscopic, I can't say that word, but anyways, that uses the light to determine the cannabinoids in there, and this comes from like, you know, expensive $1,000 machinery that when you guys send your testing into a lab to get it sampled, you know, they're using super expensive machinery, but this basically puts it in the palm of your hand for literally only $1,500. And you know, you don't have to pay a per test fee. Once you buy this unit, you can do as many tests to get the standard THC CBD analysis as you want. You could test it every 5 minutes if you wanted. I mean, there's a battery in here, it's USB chargeable. And so you just need to keep it charged up and don't let it totally decharge, because you're gonna lose the battery power over the time. And that's how it works. So it's super simple, super easy, one-time purchase. Now they have a subscription model that's gonna come out in the future if you wanna determine moisture content and other different cannabinoids in there. And that's gonna be really cool, because they want you to keep you in the game, keep you in the system, and allow them to keep being funded and continue to make improvements to this device. But as it is, I mean, I saw it work yesterday, and we're gonna try it today with my own industrial hemp here that I bought. And so all you do is you basically take a grinder, because you gotta grind it into fine. And once again, this only works with the flower, whether you have, you know, some trim like I have here, or whether you have whole flower, you're gonna put it in the grinder. And this is just like, you're just gonna grind it down. And then in here, this is like a funnel, and you're gonna put it on this little plate, but you can't just put it on the plate, because it's gonna go everywhere. So then they got this little adapter thing you're gonna put on top of the device, and then you're basically gonna take this little funnel thing and you're just gonna grind into this. So you're just gonna just grind it like you're smoking it, but you're grinding it, and you wanna grind it all up. So basically we're grinding it down to the size of like pepper. Like, right, if you're putting like pepper on your, black pepper on your stuff you're eating at night, We're just grinding this all down. Hopefully we got it all ground down. Got to keep going a little bit more. And we want to fill up that little cavity as much as possible. You don't want to have too little, because then you're not going to get a good sample. The light kind of goes up and then it refracts and reflects. And so you want to make sure that cavity is done. And the cool thing is, this does not destroy your weed or your cannabis or your hemp, whatever. You can still smoke it or do whatever you want. Some of the other testers here, you got to put in alcohol, you got to put in oil, you got to do all kinds of crazy stuff to it. And then I don't know if I'd be smoking that stuff. All right, so let's grind this up some more. I think we're probably pretty good. All right, and then we got a little cavity full. And now you want to stomp it down, right? You want to make sure we're getting good contact against the light to make sure you're going to have good reading. So they have this little stomper here, and we're just going to go ahead and take it. We're going to stomp this stuff down. Stomp, stomp, stomp. All right, that's as easy as it is. And now the next thing is we need that cell phone. And then we're going to go ahead and get the reading on there. So this app is so easy to use. All you do is you hit one button, measure now, right? It's fully connected through like a Bluetooth on here, and it's actually going in there and measuring instantly. Some of the other testers you guys are gonna see in this episode may take 10, 12 minutes to work. This is actually an instant reading, and it's still working. So we'll see how long it takes. And there it is. All right, total says less than 2%. So this is industrial hemp, so it definitely better be below 2%. CBD is 11%, so I think this was sold to me. I think it was supposed to be between 13 and 16. My memory does not serve me totally right now, but I think that's about accurate. And then it has a 7% moisture level and 0.4 water activity. And that's how this device works. You know, I would want to do sampling more to kind of make sure it works for me. But basically how they work this is that they took expensive ass machinery that does the high expensive lab testing, and they run tests through that, and then they see the form wave that it creates on the machinery. And then they basically put that same exact sample in here. So they basically get the two waves, and then they basically make software that correlates. Okay, when this cannabis and the expensive machinery looks like this wave, and we put it in this and it looks like this wave, they basically correlate them so that they know this machine is pretty much accurate. I think it's just like 1 to 3% accuracy. So, you know, according to my test here, it seems pretty accurate to me. And if you guys want to learn more about this, you want to check them out at findpurple.com. Amazing testing device. The next exhibit I want to show you guys is actually Green Life Biotics, and they have microbial inoculants. And the cool thing about their product and their claim of fame is that they actually GLB removes salts and heavy metals, cleans nutrients, and cleans plants. So this can be important if you're kind of growing and you have too much buildup, right? The microbes basically are digesters, and they're the best way to basically lower the salt contents if you guys need to do that. Of course, they basically balance the system out. So let's learn about these microbes and why they may be better than some of the other ones I've shown. All right, so this is their microbial product here. And you know what? Here's the thing. I'm not here to get into a pissing match of what microbial product is better, you know. My personal opinion on this is that every microbial product can be beneficial. And how you know which one is the best? You're not going to know. Your soil will know. So my goal is, like, if you go to a, you know, buffet here in Las Vegas, right? They got pizza, they got spaghetti, they got fish, they got cows, they got chickens, they got, you know, vegetarian plant foods. They got all kinds of different stuff. So when you go into a buffet in Vegas, there's going to be something you will be eating, right? And the problem I see is that, you know, if people are just focusing on only these microbes, right, there's so many other microbes that do so many different other tasks that you may not have in your garden, and then things are not going to work properly. So trying to introduce the biggest, broadest spectrum and range of microbes and put them in there and then let them figure it out, right? Some of the microbial products I've shown you guys already have been created in labs, maybe made by cow manure, you know, and this one is actually kind of more made more naturally. What they do is they basically grow crops on land, so then in the soil there's the microbes, and they basically take the microbes out of the soil and put in a bottle, basically, and that's basically how this stuff works. So, you know, they've been working on this procedure and practice for many years now, and while they do list like 9 different microbes, there's probably significantly, or there are more in there than they're claiming, and who knows what they are or what they do. But all I know is that this product will get you guys some results, and I want you guys to experiment, right? Maybe you buy some of their different microbial products that I've recommended in this episode and try them. See which ones give you a difference and see which ones don't. And then when you find out the ones that do make a difference, those are the ones you needed, you know? So I'm not gonna say this is better than that, or I don't really know. What I wanna do is I wanna get all the different microbes, put them on my garden, and let my garden figure it out, right? And that's just my way of doing things. So if you guys want to learn more, you can check them out at greenlifebiotics.com. So the next exhibit I want to show with you guys are actually Crop King seeds. So if you guys are looking for seeds and not clones to grow your plants out that can get shipped to you anywhere in the United States, you guys can contact Crop King. They have the dominant as well as CBD dominant, including a hemp strain that should be 50 state legal, although you may have to check your agricultural laws and agriculture department to see if it's legal for you to grow. That being said, you know, any seed, you know, base seed or CBD seed, the seed itself is not illegal. They sell these guys in head shops, dispensaries, sometimes even gas stations in the US as a novelty, right? They say that you could eat these seeds and eat a bunch of them and you will still pass a drug test. I don't know that I'd, you know, try to duplicate that. But if you ate the same poppy seeds at a health food store, you would fail the drug test, right? There's so low THC content in these seeds, you know, that's why they can be sold and freely traded as collector's items, right? But the minute you start to germinate that seed, that is when you kind of get into that gray area and you will probably be likely, but check with your lawyer on that one if it's not legal for you guys to grow in the state that you reside. Anyways, let's learn more about the Crop King seeds. So now I want to show you guys more about Crop King seeds right here. And check these seeds out, right? These seeds are like in little packages. These are like collector's items, right? Some people just buy these as obviously as a collector item. And they come with the little seeds as well as a little pin, like collector pin. So like, man, I want my kid to be collecting seeds when he's a kid. My brother's kid collects like baseball cards. I want my kid to collect these and have like a collection of the seeds. That'd be so cool, man. But you know what? This collection will set you back because these seeds ain't cheap. I mean, you guys are used to buying maybe home gardening seeds like a pack for $2 or $3. These ain't no $2 or $3 seed packets, guys. Like 5 seeds, seriously, depending on the seed, the variety, and all this kind of stuff, right? What kind it is, they can range in price from like $70 to $100 for just a little, only 5 seeds. So if you guys aren't spending that much money on your seeds, right, I want you guys to make sure you germinate them properly and don't just do that some half-ass stuff. These are very valuable seeds and priced accordingly, right? So I'm glad to say that the Crop King, you know, they want to guarantee your success with your germination. So they come out with a little germination guide. Very important you guys follow this guide so you guys get the optimal results when germinating your cannabis seeds here. And so, you know, basically you got to have proper moisture, warmth, and darkness. They go over the whole process and make it idiot proof so even an idiot could germinate their seeds. And in addition, they take it one step further, right? They give you guys a 24-hour hotline, toll-free number you guys could call if you guys are having problems with germinating to walk you through the process to help you out. Now, so as you guys know, I'm not a big fan of like the dominant seed varieties. While they do have many of those, standard feminized seeds, regular seeds, autoflower seeds here, and actually check this one out, right? This one right here, this one is cool, right? This is a freaking kitchen house plant, right? This is like a ruderalis dominated variety, you know, versus a sativa or indica based. And so this one gets no taller than like seriously a foot and a half, but you know, grows lots of buds and it's an autoflower. So here's the thing, if you guys haven't grown flowers before, or you know, the plants before, and you guys are like home gardeners transitioning in, I highly encourage you guys and actually only recommend you guys actually buy some auto flowering plants where they have a nice selection of different auto flowering dominant varieties, because the auto flowering, even if you, I don't want to say even if you screw up, but as long as you keep your plants healthy, they're going to automatically flower for you without having to mess with the fertilizer or the lighting and doing all these crazy things that the leave to the expert growers, right? That being said, the other thing I like about the company is that they have CBD dominant varieties, and that's on this rack right here. And unfortunately, this peg is empty right now because this peg was their industrial, you know, with low below like 0.3 in there, but they still have plenty of other CBD dominant varieties. So probably my favorite is the this one right here. It's a CBD auto cheese. This is the dominant CBD variety that's auto flowering. So when I do grow, and it is legal for me, this is the one that I'll definitely be growing. And so I think that's pretty much it I got to share with the Crop King. But here's the thing, man, since I'm here, you're watching me, we got you guys a 20% off discount coupon, one time use only. You're going to go to cropkingseeds.com and put on the coupon code ckshow.com to get you guys 20% off on any of their seeds. All right, so I've seen lots of different coconut couriers here at the Cannabis Expo here. And I want to show you guys the favorite one that I found at this time, right? I heard there's another manufacturer coming out with one maybe next year, March, that may be better than this one. But, and I'm gonna get some samples hopefully when that happens. But until then, this is the one that I like the most because they're making a good, consistent coconut coir that's properly washed. They even have an organic version that's buffered with low salts. You know, most buffered versions may not be organic. So they got something a little bit different than what most people have. So let's head over to Gorilla Boost and learn more about the best coconut coir. So this is the Gorilla Boost coconut coir. They have it in two formats. Mainly you're gonna probably see it in the already pre-expanded format. And I'll tell you, right, expanding compressed coir, it's not one of my favorite things to do. Like, it always seems it takes like 2 days to like totally expand. But this stuff's already basically pre-expanded, and here's, check out this quality, right? Look at that. You know, very little fiber in there, lots of nice, you know, particulate in there. And oops, and it fell over, and I'm creating a mess. But here's the thing, like, you know, why am I not filming at other coconut coir companies, right? Well, the reason is, in one word, inconsistency. Oh my God, there is so much inconsistent product coming out. I mean, I know one of the local companies here that sells coconut coir, and some people, sometimes they'll have like a good batch, and then sometimes they'll get a bad batch, and then people will stop using them because they had a bad batch, right? Not so with the coir here, right? They have consistent batches each and every time because they have basically refined their process of creating the coconut coir to basically use less water in the washing process instead of just spreading it on concrete pads and hosing it down to try to wash out some of those salts, right? They have basically a bath system where they basically bathe the coconuts to remove all the salts properly. And you know, here's the reason why this is in the episode and other coconut companies are not, is they have this little chart right here, right? This chart is a media analysis of just basically other brands' coconut coirs they basically bought, and they sent into labs to see where the salts and where the different nutrients fall, right? And the main thing that's important for me is the soluble salts in there, right? So for example, and I'm not gonna pick out any brands, but I will. Let's see, oh my God, this is insane, dude. Like, Royal Gold Perlite Mix, right? In there, and I'm saying that, that's because it's on the form here. In there, coconut coir, it's 1.78 soluble salts, right? In the readings that they're doing, right? Now this stuff, the Gorilla Boost Premium Cocoa is 0.24, right? If you have extra salts coming in with your coir, that could mess up your grow, not good, right? Because you're not controlling for that, and it just could throw you out, right? So that's one reason, right? Low salts, because they're doing proper washing. I mean, you can see like different potassium levels on here too. Like, the potassium levels on some of these other products are insane. Like 291 on the Royal Gold Perlite Mix. On theirs, it's like 41. So a lot lower in potassium. And once again, potassium, what is that? That's a salt in the end, right? Or mineral. In addition, the one thing that's unique to the Gorilla Boost brand is that they have a organic, certified organic buffered variety. And that's what this is. And other companies don't have a certified organic buffered variety at present time. And yeah, so, I mean, that's the thing. If you're trying to grow organic, have the best quality coir that's properly washed, you're gonna get consistent results every single time. I mean, basically, this is the stuff you guys wanna use, all right? So if you wanna learn more, you can check them out at gorillaboost.com.
All right, so as you guys can see, I basically got kicked out of the MJ BizCon, actually, because it's past the time. They closed today at 3, normally they go to 6, and currently it's 3:53, so I was filming until I got kicked out, and plus all the exhibitors were basically packing up, so then I couldn't really film anyways. So, you know, I basically started the day with like a whole pack of business cards, like 20-something odd cards of places I wanted to show you guys, each and every one, let you guys know like what's going on here and the booths that I thought were most important. Unfortunately, I missed 8 of them that I didn't get to show you guys. So I'm gonna sit here outside in a podcasting booth and kind of go over each business card and share with you guys their website and specifically what they do and what you guys didn't get to see in this episode. Before I go on, I do want to say that this was a very, very valuable conference to me. And I mean, yeah, it's great to show you guys the product. It's great for me to learn about the products, but more importantly for me, it's about networking and meeting, you know, some of the people behind some of the companies and some of the different products and creating a direct connection with them. I mean, that's like super critical, super important. And I mean, you just can't do that if you're sitting at home. So, I mean, I'm sure there's thousands or even tens of thousands of connections that were made here for business ventures, for other ventures, for partnerships, and all kinds of stuff happening that I'm not even aware about. I will say that's the most valuable thing to me. I've made some really good lasting friendships and partnerships for hopefully in the future will help me and also help you guys out there to grow better food by learning and connecting with some of the companies that I shared with you guys to this point, all right? So anyways, let's go ahead and next share with you guys some of the companies you guys didn't get to see in this episode that I would have filmed, but I had to kind of like shove them down to the bottom because the ones I showed you guys were the most important. So the first booth I want to show you guys that I was going to show that they were closed down when I tried to go there, so I went to Arabico because that kind of is like a similar thing. I really want you guys to get in the whole thought process when you're growing organic is that you don't really want to spray even organic pesticides if necessary. That's like maybe like your fourth line of defense. First line of defense is number one, grow healthy plants, use the techniques that I share. Healthier plants have a stronger immune system and are more able to better fend for themselves in nature. Also create, you know, good quality, you know, chitin digesters in your soil. So that's gonna basically make your plants immune to like, you know, chitin based insects like soft bodied insects, all right? That's number one. Number two is then use the beneficials. Beneficials are very important and they can keep the, you know, the bad guys in check. That's only if you get them out in time. So like even do pre-releases before, you know, say like every spring you always get an outbreak of spider mites, right? Before that occurs, the day before that, bring in the beneficial spider mite predators so that they're there. So when the spider mites show up, they can eat them and keep them under control before it gets out of hand, and then you're trying to basically catch up to a losing battle, right? After that, then I would recommend spraying, but I don't recommend spraying any kind of pesticides, even organic. I recommend spraying high pressure air or water if you're able to do that to dislodge soft body insects off the plants. In addition, I do recommend manual controls. So we have fingers, hire some kids, maybe your kids, somebody else's kids, neighbor kids, hire people to pick off bugs off the plants or smush them, right? This way we're not adding any toxicity to our plants, right? After that, then I would say that's when the organic pesticides come into play. And like the one I like the most is Dr. Zion's. Remember, I'll put a link down below because that's actually a non-persistent organic approved pesticide. And then there's plenty of other ones that you guys could use. I've shared some of the biocontrol pesticides, which I kind of prefer more than some of the ones that have more lasting residual effects in your garden, including like any kind of oils like the neem oil. Although I have used that in the past, it's my goal now to actually try to not use it as much as possible. I do on rare occasion, I do spray that when I have, you know, an outbreak that I cannot control through other methods, all right? So that being said, I was visiting Coppert, but they were packed up by the time I got there. It's K-O-P-P-E-R-T, they're at C7814, and that's Coppert, K-O-P-P-E-R-T.com. And they ship from multiple locations. They're basically beneficial insectary supplier of all the different beneficials. I think they do have a home version website, which I forget the website is, but their main website is copper.com. But I like that they actually had a home version. And they're the producer. You know, a lot of people may be resellers of beneficials, and if things are getting, you know, passed between hands and then get to you, they might not be alive. So I really want to encourage you guys, if you guys do get the beneficials, make sure they're shipped next day air, and so you guys get fresh bugs that are gonna work for you instead of ones that are not alive, right? That's number one. All right, number two, I was gonna show you guys is this one, Dinolite, C7219, it's dinolite.us. And they make digital microscopes that can hook into your laptop or maybe even cell phone, and basically just blows things up. Not like blows them up as in like a bomb, but basically it super magnifies, you know, things happen into your leaf, so you can identify pests or, you know, problems with disease on your plants. And then you could send that picture off to people so that they could diagnose what it is. Or like if you're trying to get beneficial bugs, you kind of need to know the target bug, and you could send that picture off to people and they'll be like, oh, you got russet mites, and use this for russet mites, right? But if you can't identify what you got, then people are not gonna be able to help you effectively. So that's why I like the Dinolite, all right? Let's see, another booth was this. This was actually tcheck.me. That's letter T, check.me. And what they had is they had a tester that actually hooked into your cell phone, and this is also a spectrometer, kind of like a reader thing, like that you could use. And unlike the one I was able to show, that's $1,500. This one's like, I would say, more rudimentary, and it was like $300. So it's like the lowest cost, but it had the least amount of features. And although it did work, I believe, and I was going to test it with my industrial hemp that I got, the CBD dominant hemp. It does not separate all the different cannabinoids like that other device can. So it's just kind of a basic tester. But I liked it because of the price point. And it makes, I mean, basically, if you're like a consumer of products, you could have this and you could test the products you're buying to make sure it is what they're saying it is, or the percentage of or, you know, cannabinoids in there. So that's why I like that. Now, if you guys are a grower, right, I want to empower growers to do their own testing and not have to use labs whenever possible. Although, I guess, final, if you are in a commercial grow, you know, you will need to get certified lab testing to, you know, give to the state, but for in-house, so that you know where you're at, so you can adjust your grow or whatever, if something is getting too hot, if you're growing the industrial hemp, you know, that's where I recommend a tester, like the one you guys saw for $1,500. Then there's this, like, a $300 version, and then they have a better one. It's actually $13,000. So this is the serious tester. This is basically the lab that you would send it off to, like in a box, like 13 grand. So this company, it's called Orange Photonics Inc. And basically what happened was, it's like a family-owned business, and like I guess the son is into cannabis, but his parents like made the same kind of mass spec, you know, equipment for testing oil and all these other things. So then the kid's like, oh, I'm gonna use my parents' technology to basically make one for cannabis. So he developed one that's like literally fits in a briefcase, and I was gonna use that to test my stuff to see where it ended up with. And I was gonna test like my stuff in the three different test ones to see like the differences and variations. Anyways, their website is at Orange Photonics, PhotoNics.com for their like pocket tester. So this tester only makes sense if like you're a super huge commercial farm and you're wasting thousands of dollars on testing of your cannabinoid products, you know, throughout the season and every year. This way you can test it yourself, do it in-house with a tool, and then only test final testing that the state requires, all right? So that's why I like that. I definitely love my tools, all right? Let's see, next thing was C9006. And they had basically a bottomless pot. So they basically had like a 1 gallon pot that basically had a zip seal that you could just rip off the bottom on, and then the bottom would fall out. So then you could take that pot and then put it on top of another pot. So basically to do your transplants, instead of transplanting and tipping the thing upside down, getting the root ball out, tapping it out, getting dirt everywhere, making a mess, and more importantly, disturbing the root ball, right? You just zip out the bottom, you put it on top of a pot, the bigger pot that you're potting up to, and you just basically bury it just that much. And then the roots will basically go into the bottom new pot, and you could bottom, you could water there, and you're not ever watering that little top pot. So I hope that I explained that well. And basically, this was at hc-companies.com, and I guess they make all kinds of containers, and they found a guy using this pot. I don't have any other info because I was supposed to go back by there, all right? Let's see, next pot. So. We have a Plant Logic pot. So actually, I did get samples of a Plant Logic because they kind of left them when they took off. These are for the Plant Logic pots, right? Every pot has their own pro and con. I like these because they have lots of aeration or drainage holes at the bottom. And while it does have like a lot of aeration holes at the bottom or drainage holes, right? From what they're telling me is, even though there's all these holes, the water only comes out this center line right here because it's at the lowest point. Unless you like massively overwater, then the water's going to come out wherever it can. So these are like basically water-saving containers. So basically you put like a gutter underneath this middle one, and all the runoff collects into the gutter, which then you can reuse or put somewhere else, and it doesn't drip out the sides, plus it gives better aeration to your root zone. Plus I like that they're square because I've never really been a fan of the circular pots. If you want to learn more about them, you can check them out at getplantlogic.com. I have two cards left. Next card we're going to go with this. This is actually this one. This is Mary.ag, M-A-R-Y.A-G, that's their website, and I just have their card now, but basically they have like, I mean, when back in the day when I was in college, I had a Phototron to grow my own cannabis inside when I was going to college, and this is basically like, this is a totally computer controlled with, it determines the temperature, how much, you know, water is in the reservoir, it has a built-in heater and cooler and lights, and it's totally controlled by your phone, 100% automatic, so you could grow a single plant, you know, for people that have an apartment or have never grown anything before, it totally makes it 100% automated and basically standard, you know, hydroponic nutrient solution that they supply. The only thing you need to do is adjust the pH and read what it says on your app, and it'll tell you how to do everything else so that you could produce your own bud fresh bud at home. I think they could. They said in, you know, in one turn, which is like, I don't know, 11 months, I think, they said you could make like 2 ounces. So like, to me, that doesn't seem like a lot. Like, oh, I could grow my own 2 ounces in like a whole, like almost a year. Why would I just buy it? But you know, here's the thing, and it's like $800, or you know, it was actually 1,100 Canadian, about 840 US, depending on the exchange rate that day. You could grow your own stuff, and I think that's definitely good if you're just totally like, just want to grow your own stuff and not have to do anything. But I really think getting involved with the growing process is an integral part of growing, and that people should do that. But I do like that it was gimmicky, and if you get somebody to grow more food or more instead of buying stuff that can be lightly contaminated, as I found out with the stuff that I was consuming, you know, I think that's a good thing, because then you know exactly what's being grown and what you're spraying on it. Last vendor that I was going to share with you guys is actually called Spinner. It says clone to flower. So literally you take clones, you put it in this device, and they can be stacked. They had them stacked too high, but you can stack them 3 or 4 high with proper bracing and securing. Basically, it basically grows like probably like more auto flower style plants that are smaller in this whole self-contained unit with like one light in the center that spun around. So it's like, I think this was 2 grand. So I think that's definitely a better deal than the $700 deal. But yeah, this is like more commercial style. So their website is spinnergrow.com if you guys want to check them out. That's all the business cards I got. My battery on the camera is almost out. I mean, I will say that I had an amazing fun time, even though it's been a lot of work and I'm so tired. I barely ate today. I just had my juice, and other than that, I only had coconut water this morning and didn't even get to make fresh juice for myself since I was out the door trying to get here to film everything for you guys, and I wasn't even able to do it all. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. If you guys did, hey, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also be sure to share this with somebody else that you may think it may benefit. Post this on all the different forums and other places so that people can be more aware about some of the best products in the industry to, you know, increase your yields, increase your harvest, increase your terpenes and cannabinoid counts. Whether you're growing or whether you want to grow the most nutritious fruits and vegetables on the planet like I do at home, all right? Also be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on my new upcoming episode coming out every 3 to 4 or every 5 to 7 days, no matter where I'll show up or what you'll be learning on my YouTube channel. And make sure you click the little bell so you get notified as my videos come out. Finally, be sure to check out past episodes. Our past episodes are a wealth of knowledge, over 1,500 episodes at this time on this YouTube channel dedicated to teach you guys how to grow the best food and medicine anywhere. And once again, anything that I teach in this episode, or even with my gardening episodes with regular vegetables, these all apply to and vice versa. So, you know, I want you guys to be crossovers, right? If you guys are growing, start growing some of your vegetables too, but don't grow them in the same grow area so that you're not risking any contamination. And if you guys are growing vegetables and it is legal to do so where you live, hey, I would encourage you guys to grow some CBD dominant hemp varieties, and you guys learn where to get some seeds in this episode.